The next item of business is a member's business debate on motion 3632 in the name of Christine Grahame on Addaction. This debate will be concluded without any questions being put. Would those members who wish to speak in the debate please press the request to speak buttons now? And I call on Christine Grahame to open the debate around 7 minutes, please, Ms. Grahame. Ms. Grahame, I thought you would have known that you had to have your card in the slot.
I will not blush.
Ms. Grahame.
Deputy Presiding Officer, I'd like to thank all members who signed my motion allowing me to have this debate, and in advance thank those who will be contributing. Also welcome representatives from Addaction to the public gallery. So what is Addaction? Until last year, frankly, I hadn't heard of this UK charity. I hadn't a clue. That was entirely my fault. But I wonder how many colleagues were also and still in the dark about this organisation and the work it does. Yet Addaction is a leading UK drug, alcohol and mental health charity dealing with 75,000 people across 100 places in the UK and 23 sites across Scotland, from Argyll and Bute to the borders. Its aim is to support people in their recovery from addiction, recognising that drug and alcohol addictions are health and wellbeing issues and not an issue for the criminal justice system. And we all know there are far too many in our prisons who have landed there because of addictions and mental health issues. And while the prison staff and health staff there do their best, the question is, should that man or woman be there in the first place? So how did I find out about Addaction? Like many of the most important things in life, quite by chance. I'd put out a call for nominations for my local hero to be my guest at the opening of the session of Parliament. There were very worthy nominees, but one stood out, and it was from a letter from a woman who had recovered her life from alcohol addiction through contacting Rod Anderson, who would be her support, and someone who had been through that recovery himself. This is what that letter said, and I quote, "He not only saved my life, he transformed it beyond recognition. He gave my children a future. I'm not the only one, there are dozens of us. He performs miracles on a daily basis and saves the lives of many. For the first time in the history of the borders, we now have a recovery community. After overcoming his own battle with alcohol, using the support of Addaction, Rod decided to dedicate himself to saving lives. Recognising the difference Rod was making, Addaction chose to employ him as a substance misuse worker. My words aren't doing justice to this selfless, unassuming man, so I'll share my personal story. A year ago, I was an emotionally bankrupt, psychologically disturbed woman. Under the threat of being sectioned under the Mental Health Act or facing an ASBO due to the number of times emergency services that attended my address, I agreed to being admitted to a psychiatric unit. Now I am a dedicated mother, attending college and contributing to society in a positive manner. His success in supporting others to overcome addiction created a need for him to create a recovery community. He spent his days off travelling all over Scotland, searching for practical advice that would enable him to create what was now needed. His vision started as a recovery cafe, which after mere months has become so much more. Rod created Serendipity, a charity which provides what our community needs. He has created a Serendipity board. We members now give the lifeline that Rod freely gave us to other addicts. Addiction will never provide cute, fuzzy photo ops. Addiction will never be a sexy, popular charity to donate to. Addiction is real, gritty, shameful, an illness which we pretend doesn't exist in our scenic, rural, pretty border towns. Rod gives inspirational quotes which reach the hearts of addicts. He freely gives a kind word, gentle hug, or kick up the backside to us all. He will forever be my hero. I owe Rod a debt which can never be repaid. End of quote. I was privileged that Rod accepted my invitation to be my local hero, and I know he'll be embarrassed by the fuss, but I know there are other Rod Andersons working for Addaction, supporting vulnerable people and helping them to recover their lives into something positive. I have since visited Addaction in Galashiels, having praised Rod. I know that it's a team effort, as they say, with a dedicated professional team of workers, complemented by volunteers, recovery champions and students, working hard to reduce harm and promote recovery with people affected by substance misuse. And here are some statistics from Borders Addaction. Front-end intervention. Intervention in alcohol and drugs, including injecting equipment provision each month. In the year, nearly 70 new people, with around 60 using the service each month. Naloxone saving lives emergency. In the year, more than 100 kits supplied, with more than 50 used in an emergency. Underplanned care and referrals. In the year, more than 450 people, about three quarters on alcohol abuse, one quarter drugs, the vast majority seen within 3 weeks. Active caseload, around 120 on the books at any time across the whole of the borders. Discharges, nearly 50% planned, with many reduced or stopping their drugs or alcohol. They have mutual aid groups with three busy groups in Galashiels, Peebles and Hoyk. And in recovery activities, employability, people move to jobs, education or training. There's a volunteer programme certificated through Borders College, a women's group run jointly with the Criminal Justice Services, and a music group which meets fortnightly in Galashiels. So, while there's all this hiatus today of a possible general election, a general election definitely, we should remember that in the everyday world, charities like Addaction simply get on with the job, helping and supporting those whose lives are falling apart, people who have far bigger problems on their mind than Brexit and whose lives are turned around thanks to Addaction, the staff and volunteers. Thank you.
We now move to the open speeches, and I call Rachel Hamilton to be followed by Colin Smith.
Deputy Presiding Officer, I welcome this debate and I'm pleased to be joining Christine Grahame in recognising the good work carried out by Addaction, particularly the Galashiels site. Drug and alcohol addiction remains a serious issue in our communities. Addiction is a terrifying disease that, when it takes hold, has the ability to destroy the person and the lives of their family and friends as well. Addaction, through its work, fights addiction. It seeks to help people with addiction issues. It helps their families, their friends and communities. For anyone who needs its services when faced with addiction. Addaction started in 2004 and is now the largest provider of drug and alcohol support services in Scotland. It has the expertise in issues ranging from early years work, community recovery, rehab, working with older people, harm reduction, education and employment. The work done by Addaction is vital for the lives of those who fight addiction and for their loved ones. Addaction is making an impact. 98 sites across the UK, 23 of which are in Scotland, including the site in Galashiels, supporting tens of thousands of people, including 1,000 families across the UK. One of those helped was project worker, as Christine Grahame mentioned, Rod Anderson from the Borders. Wanting to give back to Addaction, he set up the Serendipity Recovery Cafe with the support of Addaction. In 2014, Mr. Anderson became a recovery champion for Addaction Scotland, then became a full-time project worker. Mr. Anderson is an example of the positive impact Addaction makes to people's lives. And of course, his story is not the only success. But let's be realistic. Drug and alcohol misuse is not going away anytime soon. In Scotland, alcohol alone claims 22 lives a week and costs £3.5 billion each year. It highlights the crucial need for charities like Addaction and also the mammoth task these charities face to fight this disease. A report from the Scottish Parliamentary Information Unit states that in Scotland, problem drug use is disproportionately high compared to England and other European countries. And in the latest available data for 2015, there were over 700 drug-related deaths registered in Scotland. 73% of drug-related deaths in 2015 were of individuals aged 35 and over, and that's despite drug use falling overall. However, Scottish Conservative research has shown that half of all Scotland's 14 health board areas, support for alcohol and drug partnerships has fallen this year. It contradicts a promise from the Scottish Government that treatment would be maintained at existing levels. Although the Scottish Borders has seen an increase in funding for these partnerships, the likes of Dumfries and Galloway have seen fund cuts by over 200,000 and Lanarkshire cut by almost 700,000. Furthermore, official statistics show over 1,100 inmates were caught either taking drugs or administering them to others in 2016. This is a seven-year high. Substance use in our country's prisons is undermining any attempt being made to rehabilitate criminals and ensure they are secure places for people to work. It's at a bit of a tangent, but all of us agree that rehabilitation of offenders is critical for society, but this remains near impossible while drug taking remains so prevalent. Tackling alcohol and drug misuse remains such a high and important issue in Scotland, and we need a focused attempt to tackle it, working with local programmes rather than a blanket approach of substituting illegal drugs with methadone without any meaningful progress in treatment. Drug and alcohol damages and even destroys our communities. There is fantastic work being done in an effort to see its devastating impact eradicated, and I am fully supportive of those efforts, efforts made by Addaction with the likes of Rod Anderson involved. I wish both Addaction and Mr. Anderson further success in his work.
I call Colin Smith to be followed by Stuart McMillan.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Can I refer members to my register of interest where it states I'm a local councillor in Dumfries and Galloway? Can I also thank Christine Grahame for tabling this motion and allowing the Chamber the opportunity to celebrate the contribution of Addaction in our communities across Scotland. Christine Grahame highlights in particular the excellent work of the charity in, the, I think her words, the scenic, rural and pretty villages of the Scottish Borders, quite rightly so. So in the short period of time I have, I want to focus my comments on the work more to the west of the south of Scotland region, in particular in Dumfries and Galloway, although many of the challenges across what are both largely rural areas are very similar indeed. I recently visited Addaction's Dumfries office, one of their 23 regional sites across Scotland, where I had the privilege of meeting with the regional service manager, Hugh Robertson. It's clear that Hugh is passionate about the work of Addaction and leads a dedicated team supporting people right across Dumfries and Galloway, working in close partnership with the NHS, Alcohol and Drug Support South West Scotland and the local social work department. Few of the team were actually in the office behind the charity's discreet front door when I visited. Instead, they were out in communities providing personalised support and help to the hundreds of people battling with drugs and alcohol addiction in the region. Addaction provides this support in a number of ways, from individual face-to-face assessments to group sessions using mutual aid partnership meetings. And they do this in an entirely non-judgmental and personalised manner, putting the goals of the service user first. And the results are impressive. In the year to date from April 2016, Addaction has had 550 people in Dumfries and Galloway leave their service, with 449 of these users attending at least one appointment. 292, or 64% of service users, achieved a planned and positive outcome, far exceeding the service's target of 40% planned and positive outcome. Now, most of those benefiting from the service were, a surprise to me, self-referrals, often turning to Addaction for support at a time of crisis, whether that's after a drink driving charge or sometimes after the breakdown of our marriage, making the challenge all the more difficult for the team at Addaction. But Addaction were there for them in their time of need, in Hugh's words, helping them find the person that in many cases their addictions had stolen from them. I was, however, incredibly struck on my visit to learn that older people make up a growing number of those facing addictions. The proportion of all male problem drug users in Scotland aged between 35 to 64 has increased from 43% in 2009-10 to 51% in 2012-13 and 73% of drug-related deaths in 2015 were of individuals aged 35 or over, and that group of older drug users is set to grow in size. This makes the recent decision by the government to reduce direct funding for drug and alcohol treatment and support services all the more disappointing. In 2016-17, the allocation to NHS boards for alcohol and drugs partnerships was £53.89 million, down from £69.2 million in 2015-16. In Dumfries and Galloway, that led to a cut in direct funding from £1.98 million to £1.53 million. And although health boards were asked to make this difference up in Dumfries and Galloway, they were only able to find £234,000 of the £452,000 shortfall. This cut led to a 20% reduction in funding for Addaction in the region, and as a result, the team were reduced from 18 to 12. However, Addaction continue to do a fantastic job right across Dumfries and Galloway. So I want to once again thank Christine Graham for bringing this issue to the Chamber. I want to wish Addaction well as they celebrate their 50th year, and in particular, I want to thank them for all the work they do in Dumfries and Galloway and right across the south of Scotland. Thank you.
I call Stuart McMillan to be followed by Ross Thompson.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. I too welcome this debate, and I congratulate Christine Graham for securing this debate. And also, I'd like to refer members to my register of interests as a member of the management board of the Moving On project in Inverclyde. And I do intend kind of touching upon some aspects of Moving On in my speech. But Christine Graham's motion certainly was helpful, and certainly it's a reminder of the Addaction exhibition in Parliament in February. I spoke to the representative at the exhibition, and generally was greatly impressed by what they had to say and how they are actually working to help many people in the areas that they cover. Addaction don't operate in Inverclyde, but we do have a range of other organisations working with those with addictions. Now, whether it's Addaction or other organisations, including this Moving On, it isn't an easy job, and it's a job that is tough to undertake, as many people with addictions live chaotic lifestyles. Now, this affects everything from the person's health, their housing situation, their family life, and also their social activity. And the challenges are vast, but the rewards are actually immense when someone actually manages to turn their life around and leaves the life of addiction. Then this shows actually that working with people and treating them as individuals and also as human beings can actually work. As the motion states, Addaction is the largest organisation of its kind. And that's where the comparison with Moving On would actually end. The Moving On are a small grassroots organisation which employs six people. They're a well-established local organisation, and in the last 5 years, 750 people have actually sought support. Now, the staff at Moving On recognise that it's impossible to help someone with that one great leap. It's actually the small steps that are required to actually move people forward. And from a personal perspective, smaller organisations such as Moving On don't actually get the national recognition that they deserve. Now, the smaller organisations, they don't have the larger staffing ability to actually promote their activity. And I don't see that as a point of criticism of any organisation, but I'm just merely stating a fact. Now, I welcome the promotion of organisations undertaking this type of work, because it's crucial that the positive activity that actually is underway across Scotland is actually highlighted. Because it's positive. We do need to hear about the positive activity and work that's taking place to turn people's lives around. Now, it's all too easy to highlight the negative situation regarding addictions and people with addictions, and there are many. However, the positive work does take place, and Addaction play their part, as do other organisations across Scotland. Now, Presiding Officer, the total number of drugs deaths in 2015 was 706, including 16 in Inverclyde. And drugs deaths in Inverclyde have unfortunately doubled in the last 10 years, and there were 33 alcohol-related deaths in 2015 in Inverclyde. Inverclyde has the second highest number of average deaths per 1,000 of the population from drugs and alcohol in Scotland, behind Dundee, and that was in 2015. This gives members of this Parliament a picture of the challenge that we actually all face. Now, I welcome the motion that we're debating today. I do genuinely thank Christine Graham for tabling the motion and bringing and securing this debate today. However, I would also like to pass on my gratitude to Addaction and Moving On and the many other organisations who work daily with people with addictions. The challenge is huge in trying to turn somebody's life around. And certainly those workers who do that on a daily basis deliver. They deserve to have a huge amount of credit and also the praise that they generally deserve. They deliver life-changing work, which truly makes that positive difference to help our fellow citizens. Thank you very much.
The last of the open speeches is Ross Thompson.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. And I would also like to thank Christine Graham for bringing this debate this afternoon. We live in a time where fatal drug overdoses kill over twice as many people in the UK per year than road traffic accidents, and where the mortality rate from drug poisoning is at its highest since records began. This puts a significant burden on our NHS to treat the consequences of drugs and on our police to enforce the law in the face of a complex and ever-expanding network of distribution and consumption. In fact, I only read last Friday in The Courier that Superintendent Derek McEwen from Police Scotland's Fife Division said it's only a matter of time before dangerous new legal highs become more widespread in Tayside and in the North East, which I represent. In these dark and challenging times, the vital work of Addaction has been a beacon of hope and optimism. Addaction has evolved over the last 50 years to develop a wide expertise in community alcohol and drug addiction support and rehabilitation, bloodborne virus treatment, bespoke sexual health advice and education, employment and welfare issues too. But throughout its 50 years, Addaction has held true to its core approach, treating people with dignity and respect, putting individual needs at the heart of its work and an unwavering belief that addiction should never be allowed to cripple or end a life, but that recovery is possible and indeed probable with the right framework of care and support. I have, however, been most struck by Addaction's work with young people across the UK. Andrew was just 14 when he started taking cocaine and ecstasy as a means of combating his Asperger syndrome. What began as a means of feeling more sociable and outgoing became a devastating addiction, which caused Andrew to suffer paranoid delusions, extreme agitation, and palpitations. Young people just like Andrew often feel isolated and unable to talk to anyone about their problems. They do not wish to anger their parents or teachers, nor do they want to feel embarrassed or ashamed amongst their friends and peers. This is where Young Addaction stepped in to provide support and treatment for Andrew, not just for his addiction, but with practical advice and guidance on managing his Asperger syndrome. Andrew now works in an IT retailer, his confidence has grown vastly, and he lives in a happy, stable, and drug-free life. I also want to take a moment to draw attention to the incredible work of Young Addaction Dundee, a successful partnership between Addaction Dundee and NHS Corner, which targets young people aged between 11 and 18. The tragic stories of young people dying as a result of drugs resonate with all of us in this chamber. We hear of new drugs emerging almost every week, of so-called legal highs having devastating consequences too. In response to this, I launched Aberdeen Against Legal Highs and lodged motions in Aberdeen City Council to raise public awareness of the dangers of legal highs. Now, I remain committed to combating the epidemic of legal highs and to making our streets safe and drug-free, and I commend the fantastic work of Addaction in contributing to this cause. Deputy Presiding Officer, the work of Addaction in Scotland and across the United Kingdom is providing specialist advice and early intervention programmes in schools and youth clubs, which has saved countless lives over the years. It has become clear to me after reading Andrew's story and hearing the many other powerful contributions in this chamber today that Addaction is more than just an addiction charity. They provide support for those who have none, hope for those who think all is lost, and a future for those who cannot see a way forward. Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer.
I now call Aileen Campbell to respond to the debate. Around 7 minutes, please, Minister.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. And like other members this evening, I'm also grateful to Christine Grahame for bringing this debate, and I'm pleased to be able to close it on behalf of the government. And like many members here, I was also able to take time to visit the Addaction exhibition and hear firsthand about their work. And also, like Ms. Grahame, welcome those from Addaction to the Parliament tonight. I'm pleased that the motion has also attracted cross-party support and the commitment in the Chamber to ensure that some of our most vulnerable people access the care and support that they need, and that this is delivered within the context of a recovery-oriented system of care. I think also, though, that the contribution from Christine Grahame was incredibly powerful and showed the transformative impact a person-centred approach can bring. Rod Anderson, that she spoke about, who works in the Borders, sounds like an incredibly special person, creating the Borders' first recovery community. And hearing that those he has helped articulated it as giving their children a future or saving their life shows how lives can be and have been turned around. If people are given the right help, if their addiction is seen as a health problem, and if the stigma can be removed. Christine Grahame is also correct to point out that addiction doesn't just happen in the gritty urban areas of our country and that it happens in our remote and rural communities too, and therefore we need to take a national approach, and we also need to recognise that it's not an issue that we can simply brush under the carpet. Our drug strategy, the Road to Recovery, is a framework that has at its heart an aspiration to support and help those facing drug use problems and their families, and to see that through a health lens. And while the strategy remains robust and relevant when it was launched with cross-party support, nevertheless, the challenges and context of tackling substance misuse have changed. We do, as others have pointed out this evening, an increasingly ageing cohort of older drug users who require particular support to help keep them safe. And additionally, the challenges posed by new psychoactive substances have been well documented in this chamber as we undertake a cross-party approach to tackling them. We continue to work with the drug and alcohol sector to look afresh at how we might make further progress on addiction issues. And the Partnership for Action on Drugs in Scotland, which I chair, is currently providing its thoughts on the extent to which we need a refresh to our thinking, whilst retaining the ambitions set out in the Road to Recovery. And I'm delighted that Andrew Horn from Addaction Scotland is part of those discussions, and I'm incredibly grateful to him and others for their energy, their commitment and their candour, which is informed by years of experience in delivering high quality drug, alcohol and mental health services to those that need them.
Yes.
Christine Grahame.
I'm delighted you've mentioned the Scottish leadership and Addaction, but can I invite the Minister, I know your diary is very busy, but to see hands-on experience, see the teamwork at Addaction and Galashiels, which is very much, so we've mentioned Rod Anderson a lot, it is a team, and I think you might find that useful.
Aileen Campbell.
Absolutely. And again, you know, when the Addaction were here in the Parliament, it was good to get a chance to speak to Andrew and to hear firsthand some of the really transformative work that they are taking across the country in lots of the different settings that they have a footprint. And I will be interested in visiting Galashiels and the Borders, particularly as it's been so instrumental, Addiction has been so instrumental in creating that first recovery community in the Borders. And again, I think that will be helpful in our ensuring that people recognise that addiction issues don't just, again, the point that you made in your contribution, don't just happen in urban centres, it actually happens across the country. And we need to make sure that that is felt and heard loudly by people right across the country. Of course, addiction isn't just around drug misuse, it also includes issues around alcohol. And on alcohol, we have taken bold action to tackle and reduce the damage that it causes through our alcohol framework for action, which includes a package of over 40 measures to reduce alcohol-related harm. And we have made progress in recent years with alcohol-related harm reducing. However, harm is still at unacceptably high levels. And with 22 alcohol-related deaths and 670 alcohol-related hospital admissions a week, we need to do more. And we're refreshing our framework and we'll build on the progress that we have made so far on that. And given the link between affordability, consumption and harm, addressing price is also an important element of any long-term strategy to tackle alcohol misuse. So we remain absolutely committed to implementing minimum unit pricing, which will tackle the cheap, high-strength alcohol that does so much damage in all of our communities. But going back and returning to Addaction do have a strong reputation for delivering high quality services, embedded lived experience and user involvement in their governance and in their service delivery. And Andrew Horn, echoing Rob and the team, Rod and the team down in Galashiels, has been supporting some work at a national level to ensure that those with lived experience can be heard as we develop policy approaches at a national level. Because we must never be complacent, always strive to improve the quality of services and seek to bring consistency across Scotland. Addaction is a national organisation, but I'm aware of the range of local statutory and third sector services that operate right across the country who provide support, much needed support, to those who have a substance misuse addiction. The development of national standards of care set out in our quality principles set out a clear set of outcomes for alcohol and drug partnerships, and a shared statement on workforce development remain critical as part of the framework within which excellence in local delivery can flourish. There remains, however, a place for innovation, and I was delighted that my officials recently wrote to Addaction to confirm that it has been successful in securing funding from the Scottish Government for a project that will pilot and test the opportunities presented by digital technology in order to reach out and engage with clients where this is appropriate. Christine Graham's motion, though, however, specifically invites us to tackle problem substance use as a health and social care issue rather than a criminal justice one. And while there is a place for the criminal justice system, the aspiration to divert people away from criminal sanction at the earliest opportunity is to be welcomed and should continue, and we should build upon that with however we move forward our drugs policy strategy and approach in our country. It must be managed well, and I'm aware of many innovative and successful schemes here in Scotland and elsewhere to ensure that those whose offending behaviour is exacerbated by addiction will be supported in a person-centred treatment pathway. This principle should be true irrespective of whether someone is in prison or not, and I recently had the opportunity to offer views on that matter to the Health and Sport Committee in looking at prisoner healthcare, and I look forward to seeing their conclusions. And likewise, this government made a decision in November 2012 to transfer the responsibility for healthcare from the Scottish Prison Service to the NHS for the very reasons set out in the motion, to ensure that those who spend time in prison can expect the same level of care and attention as those receiving help in the community. The responsibility for drugs policy moved in April 26 from the justice portfolio to within my health portfolio, demonstrating this government's commitment to look at the issue of substance misuse through a different lens and to address it in the wider context of the public health challenges that we face. So to conclude, Presiding Officer, I want to further congratulate and thank Addaction and those like them for all they do and renew my commitment to tackle this problem in a fresh way, drawing on the expertise and perspectives available, including those with that lived experience. Because Christine Graham is right, as we debate Brexit and prepare for another election, groups like Addaction are saving lives and giving children a future and providing much needed support. We need to continue to look at addiction through a health lens in order that we continue to make the progress that we need and our country needs to ensure that public health in Scotland can ensure that everybody, regardless of the health issues that they face, can get their fair chance to flourish. Thank you.
This meeting is closed.